We're back in the Foxy Forum on the Toys for Twats night, and we have Dr. Cat, who is ready on the line with her music from George Michael. So, Dr. Cat, welcome.
Hello. Thanks for having me on the show today.
Aloha. You're out in Hawaii, right, dear?
I am out in Hawaii, yes.
Terrific. Thanks for being here. We were so excited. Dr. Patty and I are so excited to have you on the show tonight.
Love your website.
Oh,
love your information.
You.
And you're our new best friend.
Thank you. I can always use more friends. No, and I totally appreciate what you guys are doing and have been listening to the show, and just great to get the good word out about sex and sex toys.
Amen, sister. I'm on your plane, you know, so there we go.
Preaching to the choir.
So my big burning question for you, Dr. Cat, is how do you review sex toys?
Let's see. Well, usually Adam and Eve sends me whatever, you know, new sex toy that they have that they're ramping up to carry on the site, or sometimes they just do kind of little check-ins, like to make sure that, certain toys you still have mass appeal. And so usually what I look for, as a clinical sexologist, I kind of do a sexological review of them, right? Which sounds a little clinical, because there are certain points I'm looking for when I use them, which is, you know, ease of use. Does it do what it say it's going to do? Like, for instance, if it's a dual vibe, you know, does it, you know, hit the clitoris and the G-spot? Is it reliable? And, you know, there's kind of this whole list. But basically what it comes down to is, when I'm using it, do I enjoy it? So, you know, usually through that list, that's how they get to the top.
Fantastic. And do you have a rating scale for how you rate them?
Basically, the rating scale, me personally, usually what I do is I get back to Adam and Eve and kind of give them more of a narrative. And then there's these rating scales that Adam and Eve has for each product on their website that everyone contributes to, not just me. But also, I've been reviewing sex toys on video podcasts lately.
Mm.
Sex Toys for Everyone on iTunes. And I basically, you know, go on there and in 2 to 3 minutes give you the lowdown on each sex toy, the positives, the negatives, how to use them, because sometimes it is not apparent as
yes.
On the show.
And they don't come with instructions generally. If they do,
right.
They're written in some other language.
Exactly.
So it's a great way to kind of, you know, make sure that people, you know, when they arrive on their doorstep, they know how to use them and enjoy them.
Have you tried the WeVibe before, Dr. Cat?
I haven't. I just actually saw that. It came up on Adam and Eve. We do carry it now, and I think it's in my queue. So I haven't gotten it yet, but I'm excited about it. It sounds great.
Well, you know, it's really interesting because Dr. Harmony and I were having a conversation between the commercial break, and she said we've got about maybe 7 or 8 toys on the set tonight, and all various types. We have the Decadence, so we have a very large dildo. We've got the Madam Butterfly. We've got one of those whips with the plug on the other end. We've got a few different things. But she asked me, and I had the WeVibe here. She asked me out of all of them. I said, I really love the WeVibe because it's something that you, especially if you have a partner to enjoy it with, it's something you and your partner can both enjoy, and that's what's amazing about it.
Absolutely, I think a lot of the. There are plenty of options out there, and when it comes down to vibrators that you can actually share, for instance, there's also a vibrator called the Big O Multi-Stage Vibrating Ring, and what it does is it fits over the man's member, and then it has a clitoral stimulator on the top of it, so that he gets to enjoy the vibration, you get to enjoy the vibration. There are just lots more options now, and I think especially the WeVibe in general, very well made, it looks to be, and very well reviewed thus far, so I'm excited to hear about that.
Well, that's great. So, I mean, you just have a fun job, Dr. Cat. I'm telling you, you know, the things that you do for a living. I love your website because it talks about the history and how you, and we're all about having a sex positive, safe forum to be able to learn these things with people.
Love that.
Do you have a recommendation for somebody purchasing their first sex toy?
Yeah, absolutely. I think basically, you know, starting with something that, you know, as you're going through a website, let's say, because it is really nice that you can shop in privacy now, and that also Adam and Eve does do discreet billing and shipping. But basically, you can go on, and I would say just start perusing. If you know that you respond really well to, like, clitoral vibration, go on there and, you know, usually a good way to search is there's on the, kind of the left side of the screen, it'll say, you know, clitoral vibes, and click in there and basically look around and find something that looks friendly to you, that it makes you think that, oh, you know, I know that I respond to clitoral stimulation. Let's try this out. And one that's, you know, looks friendly, looks easy to use, and start there. And it doesn't have to cost you a ton of money either. That, you know, just kind of get your foot in the door and start somewhere with it. And just to experiment with it is really nice. And also, too, if you want to include your partner, it's a great way to spend a date night at home, too.
It is kind of sexy to sit and search a sex site together with your partner. It's some of that anticipation.
It's fun, yeah.
It's just too bad that you have to wait for shipping. Will Adam and Eve ship overnight?
We do. We do actually ship overnight. And, you know, to me, when you're on, you know, a sexuality-oriented website or on Adam and Eve, the whole point is, you know, giving yourself permission to explore. You know, it's mm-hmm. very permission-giving. And there are a lot of people out there who are really interested in trying some of this stuff out and trying a sex toy out, but they need to be able to give themselves permission to do that. So I know I spend a lot of my job doing that, and it sounds like you guys do too.
Sounds like sex toys are a really great way. They're sort of the gateway to mm-hmm. sexual communication.
They're
probably the safest conversation to be able to, I imagine, to be able to have with your partner to actually lead into maybe other forms of sexual experimentation you may be considering later on in your marriage. Once you've had that safe conversation with something else and your partner's receptive, later on having conversations, maybe if you're wanting to go to a nudist resort or wanting to swing or whatever, may become a little bit easier.
Yeah, it's all about establishing a dialogue, and I truly think the earlier you can do that in a relationship, the better, because you kind of set your pattern, you know? And the beauty, though, is, I mean, you can always break a pattern. I mean, if you've been together 10 years and you've never broached the subject, now might be the time. And just by talking about it, that might titillate your partner enough to do something. So that serves its own function.
What's your favorite sex toy, Dr. Kat?
You know, one that I really like is it's called the Cyberglass 4-Way G, and it's really pretty. It's one of the...
Sounds like a car.
Yeah, it's beautiful. It looks almost like a piece of art, and what's nice, it's non-porous, so it's really easy to clean. It targets the G-spot. It's double-ended, even. You know, and so you can use it in basically more ways than one, and I think it's a really good price point for what it does for you and a great material. Plus, it's attractive.
Can we get that at Adam and Eve?
You can, and actually most of the toys that you mentioned this evening, Adam and Eve deals directly with the manufacturer, so they carry most of them. We have over 19,000 products.
Wow.
And I would be happy to go ahead, if you guys are okay with it, to give you my personal discount code for everyone out there to use if they'd like.
That would be fantastic.
Great. You can go to adamandeve.com right now and get 50% off almost any item, plus free shipping and a free mystery gift when at the end of the checkout you enter the code Dr. Kat. That's DRKAT.
DRKAT, and that's 50% off plus a mystery gift plus free shipping?
Yep, you got it.
Wow, that's an amazing deal, sweetie.
Jim's over there ordering the Wii Vibe and the other recommendation she made right now. He's over there.
All right.
Dr. Harmony's husband is so busy.
You got it.
What are some other fun things that you do besides the sex toys with your business, how you're helping people?
Oh, sure. You know, I've got a private practice, and I do a lot of Skype sessions now with people. So you can find out more about that information at drkat.com. That's, again, drkat.com. And I do a lot of writing for the Internet, for different magazine publications. And probably the most fun thing I do is an iTunes podcast, an audio podcast, with my gay boyfriend named Sex Chat with Dr. Kat and her gay boyfriend. And we publish every week, and it's on iTunes, and it's a hoot. We talk about celebrity sex, we talk about products, and we answer Q&As from a gay and a straight perspective.
That's beautiful. That'll be added to my podcasting list now.
Ooh, thank you. It's lots of fun, I must say.
How did you end up out in Hawaii? How long have you been there?
You know, I've been here 6 years, and I had originally looked at setting up a retreat-style business, doing intensives with couples, and it's kind of expanded out from there. I was originally in the Bay Area. That's where I got my training as a clinical sexologist and a marriage and family therapist. So, and part of the work I do is on the Internet, so I can do a chunk of it from wherever, and, you know, Hawaii is a pretty good place to do it from.
Well, you know, we do these fox hunts where we have excursions where we go to different parts of the country. We should probably do a Hawaiian fox hunt, don't you think?
I think we should, and maybe package it up with some sort of an intensive weekend with Dr. Kat.
Absolutely. Let's discuss.
I think that sounds like a great time. So can we get you back on the show again, Dr. Kat?
Anytime. It's been a pleasure. And again, I love what you guys are doing. And oh my gosh, I almost wish I was in Florida. It sounds like you're going to have a great time New Year's Eve. So,
well, if you'd like to come out.
You know, do they have swing clubs in Hawaii? I was out in Hawaii, but I didn't find any.
Mm-mm. No, you know, it's funny. Basically, on Oahu, there are more like in-home swinger parties. There isn't kind of a larger scale club or anything, but people are definitely hooked up here, though, still. I mean, there's definitely still the community happening. It's just on a smaller scale.
I do know, too, that I'm a nudist, and I love going to nude places wherever I travel. Oh. There's a beautiful nude beach there, isn't there?
Oh, my gosh, there are several. And, yeah, I mean, there's nothing better than, like, body surfing naked. You know, you can't beat it.
God, I want to go to Hawaii next week.
Everything is better naked.
True.
Well, Florida doesn't sound so bad, though. You guys, you know, you get the good winters, too, so that's great.
Well, we've loved your interview, Dr. Kat. Thanks so much for joining us and doing the good sex-positive work that you do, honey. We're right in your philosophy, sweetheart.
Great. Thanks, and let's keep in touch for sure.
Okay, we shall.
Thank you, Dr. Kat.
Thank you.
Aloha.
Aloha.
Aloha.